In spite of the market strength this year, there have been opportunities on the short side. Probably the most interesting one is in the consumer discretionary sector, the retailers. The retailers are seeing their business model change significantly as mall-based, store-based retail is being supplanted by online retail. And that's caused several of the department stores and traditional retailers to struggle, some closing stores, some filing bankruptcy. So this has been a profitable place for us on the short side. On the long side, we like stocks with high visibility of earnings, high visibility of dividends, and the defense stocks have those characteristics. We also think that the current political environment and geopolitical environment is favorable for those stocks. And these businesses tend not to be as correlated to the overall economy, so they can do well even in low economic growth. I think for the remainder of 2017, there are two main market risks. The first is the price of crude oil. There's been a large increase in unconventional drilling domestically that's caused the United States to continue to be able to manufacture crude oil cheaply. The OPEC cartel does not have the amount of impact on the prices that it used to. So if we have continued crude oil price weakness, that could be a big risk for the overall market. Secondarily, if the Federal Reserve were to continue to raise rates, they've already raised rates twice this year, and growth hasn't been that strong, inflation's been subdued. So to the extent we continue to see weak growth and the Fed sticks by a predetermined timetable that they're going to continue to raise rates, that would be another risk, in my opinion, for the rest of the year.